Evernote and Notion have been at each other's throats. These are productivity apps. Evernote and Notion have been competing for the last few years as Notion has clearly taken over as the number one note-taking and all-in-one productivity app. But I want to take Evernote and Notion and see how Evernote actually stacks up to Notion now, because I feel like it's just so far gone that new people to productivity apps haven't even heard of it. So what is the difference between Evernote and Notion? Notion is amazing and it has a bunch of different databases, but what you get with Evernote is actually pretty solid as well. This used to be used by many people for their organization. As you saw in the Evernote home video I made, this is a really nice daily area that you can look at. And just diving into something like this first notebook here, it is a really solid place to take notes and have different functionality overall, because it can be things like your to-do list or just basic notes going on. And the reason I'm typing in like that is because I want to show the search functionality and the difference that you have between this and Notion. If we go back here and type basic notes going, I'll actually get something to populate in Evernote. The search functionality in Evernote is actually pretty solid. But if I go into something like this, right, I actually have an example page here. So this post outline for this, I would do the exact same thing. So if I do example notes right here, and then I were to go to my home page, I press Control P, example notes right here, it actually does a decent job of doing this. And this is something that's pretty new with Notion. The search functionality has never really been that great, but they've improved upon it in the last few years. And you can actually filter it as well in here, which is really nice. You can do something like quick filters that they have here, created by me, more filters, like I can take what page it's supposed to be on, when it was created, who was created by, last edited by. So they have improved it a lot. And you actually have the option to only match titles of things as well. So while Evernote may have had them there, Notion is actually improved enough to catch up in some respects. So an only real way that you can actually do any sort of project planning in Evernote is by having your notebooks be the organization, which I'm not really sure how I feel about. I don't like this functionality regarding like, hey, let me make a project with a bunch of different notebooks. So these are the notebooks that I have, right? And in order for me to organize projects here, I'd have to like use the functionality of notebooks in order to do projects. So say I were to make a couple of these and add them to a new stack. So if I add a new stack, and call it YouTube, and stacks are commonly used for grouping notebooks that have a similar topic, then I could maybe drag a couple of things in here where I would be able to take this side hustle notebook, maybe move this into the YouTube one. And sure, what you can do is you can organize your different areas of your life in these stacks and maybe have organization in that way. I could do something like having your different videos and scripts in there, and that's fine to a certain extent. But while there is tag functionality for different things, I could do YouTube videos, video, and create the tag for it. Nothing is quite like the fact that you in Notion can take something like a series of pages and turn it into a database that looks like this. So this is what I like to call a root in my task management system. It's a continuous project. It's like an area of responsibility in the PAR method. You really just can't do that with things like Evernote. It doesn't really work in comparison. You can stack notebooks all you want, but it just doesn't look as good to have that view. And the different views that you have are cards. So you could go through and look at it like this. You can go and look through snippets, see the side lists and a top list, but it just doesn't do it the same amount of justice, in my opinion, as what like a calendar view would do. And while you can add filters, and I'll give it credit here that you can add different filters to the different notes of something, this is pretty solid for something like notes for school or meetings, but project-wise, I don't think it does the same kind of stuff. Now, from a customization standpoint, I think Evernote Home is actually pretty solid. You get to look at your different things on your page from like a solid point of view. You know, I could take my life and have most of it in the note-taking and calendar section and maybe even some basic tasks on a homepage, but it's still limited to the amount of different widget space that you have. And if you look at the pricing for Evernote, I mean, you get a couple extra widgets on the homepage for $8 a month. On Notion, I can do all of this for free. I mean, if we look at the pricing plans for Notion, you get unlimited pages and blocks, share it with 5 guests and sync across devices. With Pro, you just get like extra version history, file uploads. It's really not a crazy amount more. And this isn't like a small max note size, but it's limited. And having three widgets that you can choose from on your homepage, not exactly ideal. Now, I will give the credit to Evernote that you can have an integration with something like Google Calendar, and there's actually even email integration and whatnot here. Like, I could forward emails directly into Evernote using an email address, and there's a nice web clipper, and I could put different things here on my homepage that look nice. So that basic level of integration is really nice. But once again, I'll point out the fact that on my actions page, I have a Google Calendar widget from a website called indify.co, and this is completely free. So you're really not getting that much more from Evernote in that regard. This is just a basic embed in Notion. And I'll give Evernote credit in the fact that it has a Slack integration, but so does Notion. With Zapier and the API finally becoming official, it's gonna keep getting improvements. And there's even gonna be sync databases for Google Calendar here soon in the upcoming year. So the main problem I see when it comes to Evernote versus Notion is you can get everything on Evernote pretty much for free, but Evernote costs you $8 a month for the personal version. I don't really see what the amazing functionality is with this, because you don't even get due dates, reminders, and notifications for free on Evernote. And yeah, offline access is nice, but I don't really see, for my purposes at least, Evernote being a viable option. But there is a lot of nice functionality for just basic note taking with Evernote. I don't give anyone any flack for using it, but I don't see how, if you wanna have like some sort of interconnected databases, you're gonna use Evernote nowadays. I personally just see that Notion is making better strides as time's gone on, and that Evernote's not really catching up.
If you guys like this one and wanna see more comparisons or ways to improve your productivity, click this video. It'll be a thing. You'll like it.